Yo, so we are back in the day. I'm gonna walk you through the best recruiting guide in EA Sports College Football 25. Recruiting made easy, boys. So it's obviously gonna vary depending on what type of school you choose. I know a lot of you boys are coming up from the slums. You're in the worst schools possible. So recruiting is gonna be extra important for all of you. Join the Discord, become a member, link down below, and let's get into the video. So first things first, what is recruiting and how does it work? Well, when you're in a dynasty, man, you gotta get some prospects. Depending on the school you are, you get a certain amount of hours, basically points to spend recruiting in the top right. You can see right now we have 525 hours to spend on all of these different players. Now, obviously, it's because I already spent some of them, just a little bit, but you can see I have a bit of a recruiting board already made. Now, how is your recruiting board to be made? What you do is you go to the prospect list. First things first, you're going to want to understand your school. So go over to your school and you can look at, I'm Purdue right now. So I'm Purdue. You can see I have a C minus championship contender, B minus program, and you have a bunch of different letter grades, basically showing, is your school going to actually be appealing to a commit? And you definitely want to keep this in mind, because if there's a commit that wants to be a pro and you have a C plus pro potential, you better not be using pro potential as a pitch idea to one of those guys, or you are going to regret it. So keep that in mind. So depending on how your school lines up, you know, my school honestly has a pretty decent amount of decent grades. So I think there should be, and it's a three-star school, so there should be enough players that are relatively interested, and I think we can land maybe one five-star, a couple four-stars, and maybe mostly three-stars. You can see, I like going by recommended. Recommended is a great filter to start out at, and what you want to do and look at is you want to actually go ahead and look, toggle on the right, and it'll show you whether or not these guys are actually interested in you. If you're not one of their interested guys, and there's a school that already, you know, is an established program, then good luck catching up, you know. And a lot of these guys have deal breakers as well. You have to toggle. We have this guy's deal breaker. We have this guy's deal breaker. But depending on the school, some of these guys, if you don't have their deal breaker, do not put them on your board, man. Like, look, let's take a look here. Right now, actually, Indiana and another school already are pretty high up on this guy's recruiting list. We could potentially make up the ground, but is it worth spending a ton of hours to even try recruiting this guy? Probably not. I'm probably better off. This is another good example. We're up there. We're top five. There's still a lot of recruiting left to do. It's just, I probably would recommend recruiting a guy like this. Now, a guy like this where you're number five and Notre Dame is number one, you must be out of your, if you recruit this guy, you're going to waste your hours, let me tell you. So try finding guys like this. Like, this is when we can compete. We can compete right here on this three-star. Is there any four? See, look, this is a four-star. He's going to Notre Dame, guys. You're not going to be able to pick out. You're not going to be able to beat Notre Dame on that one right there. This one, it's pretty competitive. Try finding diamonds in the rough. Really find guys that people are. Like, look at this. This guy's a four-star, and we're basically tied for number one. You throw him on the board. You recruit him. So let's go take a look at how to actually scout and recruit. So I put this guy on my board, then what? Well, what I recommend doing is scouting him out. Go in there, you offer him a scholarship, depending on the scouting. I should not have offered that first. You can see you spend 10 points, and you can see, all right, looking at his stats, you know, his lead blocking is pretty high, his strength is really high, his speed is pretty mid, but he's a left guard, so who cares? His lead blocking looks really, really good. I'm actually gonna finish up scouting, and he has 90 strength. This is a decent four-star player who I am interested in, so then you go ahead and you offer a scholarship. Now, let's just go ahead and offer all these guys scholarships. We'll scout out a little bit just for the sake of this video. We'll see if we can find any gems and whatnot. This guy's already scouted out. This guy, we offered a scholarship, but isn't scouted out yet. So make sure you're, if you're a recruiting coach, make sure you're going in there and you're spending your points, because you can recruit players faster depending on what you're actually spending those recruiting points on. And just look at that. Look at this. So this guy is a bust. So just because he's a bust doesn't mean you take him off your board. You have to look at his stats. Looking at his stats, I can tell why he's a bust. Some busts actually have decent stats and are worth potentially getting. This guy just sucks. So it's a good thing. That's why you want to scout. You scout him out. This guy has terrible stats. You back out and you remove him off of the board. So now I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to sim to the next week. And I'm going to show you guys what to do as you progress through the season. So a really important point is you kind of want to find your guys that you're interested in week one, and go all in on them, guys. You want to try locking these guys up as soon as possible, or you are going to, you're going to have a tough time, man. Things get really competitive. You want to try being a team's number one from the start. And if you can't get to a team's number one, then trust me, you're going to lose out on a lot of your guys. And you're going to be spending a lot more hours than you probably wish you would have. Look at this. See how we're number one right now? There is a school with number two catching up. So right now, currently, I'm DMing this player. 10 points out of 50 have been spent. You can spend, you can remove. So I'm going to remove that DMing. And I'm going to go ahead and send the house. Let's just pretend this is the guy I want. And I'm just going to go ahead and full send the house. And we will make up a good amount of points. If you also look at the end of the influence bar, it tells you what round you're in, basically. Right now, we're going for the top five. And once that bar says commit, you know, this one says top eight. So just because we're losing, we still have a lot of time. It'll say top three, and then it'll eventually say commitment. So that's also a good point to be keeping in mind. Like right here, do we really have a chance? This guy is, Illinois is pursuing him, and he's from Illinois. Yeah, this is probably a guy that I'll probably remove off of my board. Just because he is from Illinois, and Illinois wants him. I smell something. It seems like he's gonna be going to Illinois. Again, anybody you really want. Now, this is a two-star guy. Do we really need him? Do you need him? I'm going to go ahead and scout him to see if we really even would need a guy like this. And honestly, the answer is no. He is 58 zone. So honestly, I wouldn't get a guy like this. But if he was good, he's a two-star. You're not going to send the house. You're going to go ahead and contact his friends and family. This is a guy you're going to monitor week to week, and if you're losing ground, then you send the house. So you keep doing that. You send the house every single time. Eventually, what you're going to want to do is instead of sending the house, you'll unlock soft sell and hard sell. Now, these things can actually, so sending the house can do, what is it, four? You get five influence gain. If you spend the same amount of points and do a hard sell is only 40 points, first off. You can get more than five influence points if you choose the right things. So that's where it comes in mind about, you know, does your school have the right things that a player wants? Keep that in mind when recruiting them, as well as choosing to substitute out, send the house with a hard sell or a soft sell, or potentially even a sweat. I mean, all of these options are very good. So basically, as these recruits narrow down their school, start removing some of these guys right here and start adding in some of these. Eventually, you're also going to spend more than 50 hours per week. You'll be able to spend 60 hours on some of these players. So what you can do is you can send the house and DM the guy, and these hours carry through week to week. So I spent 50 this week on this guy, right? I'm sending the house. Next week, I'm also going to send another 50, and that's why I'm not starting out at 600 hours, because I have a bunch of hours already locked in on these guys. I'm actually going to go ahead and advance a season. Sim the next season. Hold on a second. Next week. I really want to see if I can find a guy. Now, I haven't recruited anyone. Like, I haven't actually went in there and sent the house on these guys. So I'm going to be surprised if somebody wants me enough to put me in their top three or whatnot. But I'm going to try seeing if we can get to a point where I can start doing some selling. Let's take a look. Yeah, we still can't unlock it. None of these guys want me because I'm not sending the house enough on them. But what I really like doing is make sure you have your board filled up to 35 targets at all times. Fill it up to 35. You know, anybody that's a bum, anybody that you're losing traction on, just remove them, man. Let's see, top three. So now that this guy, now I'm in this guy's top three. Now you can go ahead, you can schedule a visit. I would do this on a week where you're not on a bye week. Do it on a week where you're going to win. On a week you're going to win, you can see you gain three influence, and if you lose, you lose. So you want to do it on a week you're going to win, or you are screwed. So you can schedule a visit. That's a really good thing you can be doing. You can also soft sell and hard sell. Like I said, let's pretend I want to hard sell this guy. Now, unfortunately, it doesn't show me what he likes. It shows me what he dislikes on some things. So you're gonna just have to gamble here. It's a very risky gamble. I would choose, you know, three things that we have that are very high in rating, because at least then, like, what's he gonna say? He doesn't want it. See, we have an A. We have two A pluses and a C right here. Will a hard sell work? It'll tell you immediately. Look at that. We got five influence points from that hard sell. That's actually pretty good. Pretty good pitch. You get to know immediately, and you can see that's gonna give us a little bit of ground following this week. Again, this guy, he's from Indianapolis, and he has his home state recruiting him. So keep that in mind too. You know, a lot of these guys are probably built into the pipeline of the schools that are number one. This guy's Florida. This guy, look at this, Georgia wants him, and he's from Georgia. and look at how competitive it is. That is way too sweaty. Back off. So I hope this gave you a good idea of how to be recruiting in college ball 25. Let me know if you got any questions. Peace out. Thanks for watching.